Module number four. Before starting this module, we will discuss about the previous lecture. Electronic configuration, hydrogen, atomic number 1, configuration 1s1, helium, atomic number 2, configuration 1s2, lithium, atomic number 3, configuration 2s2, 1s2, 2s1. Instead of 1s2, it is as similar as the helium. So here we can write helium instead of 1s2. So therefore, atomic configuration can be write like this. Instead of complete inner configuration, we place equivalent noble gas element of filled electronic configuration. So 1s2 is the configuration of helium. So instead of 1s2, we replace here helium. Configuration of lithium will be helium and 2s1. Remaining electron will be placed in second subshell. Beryllium, atomic number 4. 1s2, 2s2. Instead of 1s2, we can also place helium. And we can write electronic configuration like this. Helium, then valence electronic configuration, that is 2s2. Boron, atomic number 5. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Instead of 1s2, we can place here helium because it is a configuration of helium. And valence shell configuration will be 2s2, 2p1. Carbon, atomic number 6. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Instead of 1s2, we place helium. Configuration will be helium, then valence shell 2s2 and 2p2. Nitrogen, atomic number 7. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. All the 7 electrons accommodate. Now, we place helium instead of 1s2. And remaining configuration of valence and configuration is 2s2, 2p3. Oxygen, atomic number 8. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. 2, 2, 4. 8 electrons will be accommodated. Now, we place 1s2 helium instead of 1s2, and remaining electronic configuration is 2s2 and 2p4. Fluorine, atomic number 9. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. Instead of 1s2, we place helium here, and remaining will be valence shell configuration is 2s2, 2p5. Neon, atomic number 10. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Instead of 1s2, we can place helium here. So remaining configuration will be 2s2 and 2p6. Sodium, atomic number 11. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 10 will be accommodated. Remaining one will be in 3s1. As we know that in previous valence shell electronic configuration of neon is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Therefore, we can place neon here instead of 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Instead of this, we can place neon here. Remaining will be the valence shell configuration, that is 3s1. Magnesium, atomic number 12. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. As we know, 1s2, 2s2, and 2p6 is the configuration of neon. So we place neon here instead of these inner subshell configuration. And remaining or valence shell will be 3s2. Aluminium, atomic number 13. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. And remaining configuration 3s2, 3p1. And inner subshell configuration of neon, just like neon, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So therefore, we place neon instead of inner configuration. And remaining or valence shell configuration is 3s2, 3p1. Silicon, atomic number 14. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. It is the inner configuration and it is equivalent to neon. Remaining will be 3s2, 3p2. So we can place 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 instead of neon, and valence shell configuration is 3s2 and 3p2. Phosphorus, atomic number 15. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. Instead of inner configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 replace neon, and remaining of valence shell electronic configuration is 3s2, 3p3. Sulfur, atomic number 16, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. Instead of inner subshell valence configuration, replace neon, and remaining will be our valence shell electronic configuration is 3s2 and 3p4. Chlorine, atomic number 17. Configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. It is the valence shell, it is the inner shell configuration that is represented by a neon. So we can write neon instead of inner shell valence shell configuration. And valence shell configuration is 3s2, 3p5. That is 3s2, 3p5. Argon, atomic number 18. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 3s2, 3p6. Instead of inner shell configuration, we write neon here. And remaining will be our valence shell electronic configuration of argon is 3s2, 3p6. Now all the valence shell is completely filled, having 8 electrons, 3s2, 3p6. So, potassium, atomic number 19. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. Instead of writing all the inner shell atomic configuration, we can write argon here because the argon configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Instead of all the inner shell configuration, we can write argon here and showing only the valence shell configuration, that is 4s1. It is the easiest way and handy. We can easily predict the valence shell configuration and we can write in detail if we require. Calcium, atomic number 20, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. The inner shell up to 3s6, 3p6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. It is same as the argon. So we can write argon here and write the valence shell configuration. Okay. Now you have to practice writing the complete valence shell configuration and writing the only the valence shell configuration with the help of noble gases or filled electronic configuration of group 8 element. Now come to the module number 4. In this module, we will be going to study about the importance of electronic configuration. Why we need this electronic configuration? It is important because valence shell electronic configuration, first we have to discuss about the valence shell electronic configuration and way how we can write a valence shell electronic configuration. Then identify atomic properties. We can predict the groups, period, blocks and chemical properties with the help of valence shell configuration. And number 3, importance of noble gases configuration. Now, importance of electronic configuration. As you know, this is important because valence electron contribute the unique chemistry of each atom. The important aspect is that we realize that knowing electron configuration help us determine the valence electron on an atom, as well as we can identify the atoms, its position, the predictable group, period, total number of electrons and valence shell electrons. We can also predict the chemical properties and behavior of elements. Here we present first 20 elements, its valence shell configuration. You have to practice hydrogen, only one atomic number 1, only one electron, and it will be accommodated in first subshell, lowest energy level subshell, that is 1s1. Helium, atomic number 2, and it having 2 electrons. These 2 electrons will be accommodated in lowest energy, sub-energy level, that is 1s2. Lithium, atomic number 3, and it having 3 electrons. 2 will be accommodated in inner subshell and one remaining one will be accommodated in second subshell, that is 2s1. We have to practice all these. Now, are you able to answer this question? Observe the diagram. Question number 1. Which atom is represented here? We have to count the number of electrons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And as we know, 7. is nitrogen. Okay. Now, what is the atomic number and atomic mass of this element? Atomic number is 7. As we know that a number of electron is equal to the number of proton. How many electrons? Atomic number is 7, mass number. Count the proton or what is present inside the nucleus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 12, 13, 14. Mass number 14. How many electrons are represented in the last shell here? Last shell, outermost shell, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 electrons. Write the electronic configuration of this atom. So, answer is, atom is nitrogen. Atomic number 7, mass number 14. Valence shell electron is 5. Well, complete configuration is 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 is 3. Practice different atoms and answer the question. Another example. Observe the diagram. It is silicon. Atomic number 14, symbol SI. Mass number 28.0855. Now, observe this diagram, answer this question. How many electrons does silicon contain? 14. How many valence electrons does silicon contain? We have write the configuration, then identify the valence shell configuration. How many electrons can the first energy level hold? It means you have to write the complete configuration, and predict the first shell configuration, count the electron. Write the electronic configuration for this atom. We have to write complete configuration. Write the valence shell electronic configuration of this element. It means only the valence shell configuration required. So first we have to write the configuration complete. 1s2 K shell, L shell will be split in two S sub shell and P sub shell. S having accommodation 2, 6 having accommodation maximum 6, P having maximum accommodation 6. Therefore, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Two shells are completely filled. Remaining, how many electrons left? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 is accommodated, 4 is left. So 4 will be accommodating 3s2 and 3p2, that is the M shell, third shell. How many electrons does silicon contain? 14, total atomic number 14. How many valence electrons does silicon contain? Valence shell is the M shell. M shell having 2 and 2, 4 electrons. How many electrons can the first energy level hold? First energy level, that is K. K having only 2 electrons. Write the electronic configuration of this atom. Write down the electronic configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Write the valence shell electronic configuration of this atom, that is 3s2, 3p2. Now, we are identify group, period, and block. Example, magnesium. Atomic number 12. Electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Valence shell 3s2. It is present in the third period. And group number is 2a because it contains the 2 electrons. Number of electrons represent the group number, and the number present before the subshell represent the period number. And ending or the valence shell configuration ends at the S subshell, therefore block is S block. So 1a, 2a. It is present in the 2a. In which period? First period is hydrogen, second, third period. So magnesium is present in the periodic table, second period, third period in 2A group, and it is the S block element. Now, iron. Atomic number 26. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10. Valence shell 2. Electron shell, it is a valence shell, it is the electron shell, it is a sub shell. So we can write, we are able to write the valence shell electronic configuration. With the help of valence shell electronic configuration, we can write or predict the group number, period number, and block. Here, we know that iron is present in 6B group and in third period. And it is, its block is G block. Do you, you do not have to repeat yourself over and over. So this is the easiest way to write the, with the help of noble gases, we minimize our work and can be represented here. Oxygen, atomic number 6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. We can write, it is the configuration of helium. We place helium here and remaining will be 2s2, 2p6. It is the valence shell electronic configuration. Silicon, atomic number 14. So before 14, we observed that the valence shell configuration is 3s2, 3p2. And we can place neon instead of inner valence, inner configuration that is resembled with the neon, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. It is a configuration of neon. So we can place neon and we can write the valence shell configuration. Calcium, observe 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 2p6. It is a configuration of argon. So we can place argon here. Therefore, valence shell configuration is 4s2. We can place 4s2. Chlorine, atomic number 17. We can write the configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. We observe that 1s2, 2s2 and 2p6 is the configuration of neon. So we can place neon instead of inner subshell configuration. And we can write only the valence shell configuration, that is 3s2 and 3p5. Importance of noble gas configuration. Why it is important? Due to the atomic weight, its stability, all the atoms try to obtain the noble gas configuration to stabilize themselves. The stability of atom depends on whether or not their outer shell is filled with the electron. If the outer shell is filled, the atom is stable. Atoms with unfilled outer shell are unstable and will usually form chemical bond with other atom to achieve stability. Observe the element present at the center, helium, complete valence shell, neon, complete valence shell, argon, complete valence shell. So they are inert. Sodium, it having one atom in the valence, one electron in the valence shell. It is unstable. Sodium having tendency to lose electron and form the cation. After losing this electron, its inner shell will be, it become the valence shell, and this valence shell is resembled with the neon. Now it becomes stable. Observe this diagram. It is chlorine valence shell contains 7 electrons. It is unstable. It's tried to stabilize themselves by gaining one electron. After gaining, its valence shell will be complete and it will become chloride ion and it will be resembled with the argon. And due to this, it will become the stable. Example of an unstable with a single electron in its outer shell, outermost shell is sodium. It is a sodium. Example of unstable atom with 7 electrons in the outermost shell is chlorine. It is chlorine. Example of stable atom are helium, neon, and argon. Okay, thank you.